गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू वेब टेक्नोलॉजीज क्लास. टुडे हियर आई एम गोइंग टू एक्सप्लेन यू अबाउट अ प्रैक्टिकल पार्ट ऑफ कोर एलिमेंट्स. ओके, फर्स्ट थियरी पार्ट ऑलरेडी आई हैव सेंट यू. फॉर दैट आई एम सेंडिंग अ प्रैक्टिकल पार्ट कोर एलिमेंट्स एंड डिफरेंट एट्रीब्यूट्स आई हैव एक्सप्लेन इन द कोर एलिमेंट्स. दैट पार्ट आई विल एक्सप्लेन टुडे. ओके, सो एज यू ऑल नो, इन ऑर्डर टू राइट HTML प्रोग्राम हियर first you need to open notepad. to open a notepad here I'm typing notepad enter notepad will open here. first I will write all the core elements HTML. next header. After that you give the title. Here I'm giving a title as core elements. Next close the head section. Here I'm increasing the font. Next, come to the body tag. Next, body. Here, I am displaying the content as core elements. Save this file as core.html, and it should be all files. And I'm giving the location as here you can see desktop. Save it. Now come to desktop. Core elements. You can see this is your core elements program. You open this with the browser Internet Explorer. Core element is a body section content. Okay. So core element here, the mainly there are four elements. One is HTML. Second one is the head. And for head, title is a inner element, nested element. Okay. Next, actually four core elements. No, one first one is HTML. Second one is the head. Third one is the title. And the fourth one is the body. So title is used to give a title to the web page. Whatever title you have given, core elements, that title displayed here. You can see here in the title bar, core elements. Okay, so now here the core element body tag, element means tags only. Here for the body section we have a different types of attributes. That attributes I will explain now. The first core element of body tag, here I'm giving text. Text equals to green. Close it, save it, come to browser window, refresh this. Okay, you can see the text color is changed into a green. So if you want to change the text color, then you can use the text attribute. So when you had used this text attribute inside the body tag, then what happened inside the body tag, whatever content you have written, all the content color will be changed into a green color. Okay, so that is a text attribute. Here text is a attribute of body element. Okay, this is a first attribute of body tag. Next, background color. Background, later we'll discuss about the background color. First I will explain background. Background means, as already explained, if you want to give a background image, then we'll use a background attribute, background. Background equals to, I want to give an image as a background. So in order to give a image as a background, first you need to find out the location of the image. Actually, where is the image? Here I am searching in the actually File Explorer, pictures. Okay, pictures, saved pictures if there. I will insert no. So saved pictures are not there. Then I'll search from a C drive, Windows, web folder. You have in web folder, you will get some pictures. I'm searching for that. Web, inside the web, you have wallpapers. Windows 10 wallpapers I want. So these are the wallpapers. Here, this wallpaper, this I want to insert. Click on this. Okay. Right click on this. You will get properties. And these are the properties of that picture. So you copy all the properties. You copy location of this. Just place your cursor here. Copy complete the path. Means it is this is nothing but the location of that. Okay, copy this. Come to notepad. Where is your notepad? You open the notepad. You copy. Now, till here you have copied the location of the image only, but you have not copied the name of the image. Here they have given, see, name of the image. Copy the name of the image and paste the name of the image and give the image extension as JPG. It is compulsory. Now after that, give the name of the image, give the file format JPG. After that, go to file, click on save. Next, come open that file. Where is your file? Means the score. Open with Internet Explorer. See, background image you will get. Instead of the plain background, here some image is displayed as a background. Okay, so this is about your background. Instead of the plain background, if you want to give any image, then you can give by using a background attribute. Here the core element, as it is, whatever I have given in the body section, that is displayed. Okay, now come to the next attribute. Okay, what is the next attribute here? I am removing this because this attribute over. No, just you need to give the background image. After giving the background image, what you have to do is give the location of the image, which image you want to insert. The next one is, what is the next attribute I have explained? BG color. Background color equals to, example, orange. Save it. Come to browser window. Refresh this. See, background color is changed. Okay, see, whatever attributes I am giving here, all those attributes are applied to only the body section. Okay, and the next attribute is link. Here you remove this, give the link. For the link, if you want to give any colors, link equals to what color you want to give. Example, for link I want to give a red color. But if you want to see this output, link should be there. To give a link, we'll use href, example, b.html. This is a syntax. Later I'll explain in the next class. Just you try to concentrate what I'm explaining. This is a link actually. Okay, save it, go to browser window, refresh this. See, already it is displaying red color. This is, when you click on this, the color is changing. Okay, by default, what color I have given? This is a visited, no? Before visiting, you see. This is link. link color specify the color. Unvisited links, you will get a red color. Okay, so again I will open the file, we'll see once again. Open with Internet Explorer. See, this link is already visited, no? So that is why it is giving a some purple color. Here I will create one more link. You can see dummy links I am giving. If links topic over, then I will explain how to give this. Okay, c.html, c file. Here I am giving save it. Come to browser window, refresh this. See, c file you are getting in red color, text you are getting in some purple color. This is unvisited link, this is a visited link. Unvisited links I am giving a red color. See, because here link in the body section, you can see body link I have given red. Means for unvisited color I am giving red color. Visited also you can give a new color like this using a v link attribute. V link equals to example green I want to give. We'll see this will work or not. Okay, save it. Refresh this. See, here instead of some different color, what color you are getting? Text. Okay, green color you are getting, no, for text. And the C file is in a red color because it is unvisited. I will click on this and we'll check whether color is changing or not. Okay, this it is not applying. See, it is a green color because both links are already visited. So if it is visited link, I am giving a green color. And active links also you can give. Active link, a link blue color I am giving. Save it. Again I am creating a one more file. Control C. Now come to browser window, refresh this. C file, active link C file. So when you are clicking, at that time you are getting green color. Before clicking you are getting a red color. After clicking you are getting a green color. So that three attributes you can include inside the body tab. Okay, so this is about attributes. So these are the attributes of body tab. So in the head section I have not explained attributes. When I'll complete first unit, again at that time I will explain attributes of head section. Okay, this is a practical part of core elements and its attribute. Now I'll explain hyperlinks program. Okay, you see hyperlinks. This is a file. What is the name of the file here? You can see it is a core.html. Now I will create a one more file. File new HTML head, next title. I am giving title as hyperlinks. Next I am closing title, close head section. Now open the body section and close the HTML. Now inside the body section I am giving one hyperlink. Here A stands for anchor tag, HREF stands for a hyper reference. Okay, using this we can give a link between the documents. Here whatever file you are writing, that is called as a source file. And to whichever document you are giving a link, that is called as a target file. So here I want to give a link to the file which I have already created. So what file I have created? Core.html. Save it. Core I am giving. You can give any hypertext. Over. Save it. What is the name of the file actually? I am giving hyper.html. You can give any name. Now all files you can see location I am giving desktop. Save. Now one more file is created. You can see hyper. Okay. Now we'll execute this file. Just a minute. I'll close this. Hyper. Open with Internet Explorer. See, this is your output. Actually, here core is a text. That core is underlined, and whenever you are moving your mouse pointer on that, it is giving some hand symbol. That is nothing but it is a hypertext. See, if plain text is there, I have given some plain text here. Core is a plain text here. Save it again. You refresh this. Core, this is a normal text and this is the hypertext. What is the difference between these two? If it is a simple text, nothing you will get. No, you won't get any different color, or it won't be underlined and it won't be highlighted with any hand symbol. So, but if you place your mouse pointer on this, you can see, because it is a hypertext which contains links to another document. And when you click on this, a new document will open. Here, see, that file is opening. Previously what I have created, core elements, no? That file is opening, because here core.html one hyperlink I have given. So you, from this file name is hyper, from hyper document I am moving to the core.html. okay, so this is a hyperlink. Okay, so using hyperlink concept, you can move from one section to another section. Okay, so this is a simple example. Here, how many files are created? Two files. One is a hyper file and the second one is a core file. So from hyper file I moved to the core file. Hyper file is called as a source file and core file is called as a target file. Okay, now here between anchor open and close I have given core. That core is called as a text. Okay, so between anchor opening and closing we have given a text. So this type of links are called as a text hyperlinks. Example, instead of the text, if I'll give image here using a image tag, img, location of the image. What is this img? Later I'll explain. Okay, so in order to open images, again you open folder, C drive, Windows folder, again go to web folder. There you have a pictures we have. This is right click on the picture, select properties, you will get the location of the picture. Copy that and paste that in a notepad. So here wherever you have given img tag, no, there you place. Now at last you give the name of the image. What is the name of the image? This is a image, no? Right click on this, go to the properties. This is the name of the image, img 100. This is the name of the image, img 100. It is a jpg file. Okay, now here you give the name of the image and it is a jpg file. Close the double quotes and close the image tag. Save it. Now come to again a hyper file, open with Internet Explorer. See image, it is displaying. Okay, if you click on this image, you can see this file is opening. Okay, or just a minute, I'll decrease the size of the image so that you will get clearly. After jpg, height equals to 100, width equals to 100. Just I am decreasing the size of the image. Same program. See, now the image size is this. See, when you move your mouse pointer on that image, it is again same symbol it is giving. Now you click on this, it is giving a new element. So what is the difference between this and the previous one? The previous one just I have given the only text, but here I have given an image, and when you click on that image, a new document will open. Okay, that is the difference between a text hyperlink and image. Means in place of text, just I have given a image. Now the third one is internal hyperlink will remove this. So for internal hyperlink A HREA equals to, here I am giving a first, you can give any name. I am giving A, you can give any content A. This is a first section. See, here I am giving name attribute you are supposed to use here, not HREF. Name. Save this. Copy this. Here name I am giving a second. Content I am giving a B, 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 B. I am giving, you can give any content. Close. Now come to the third section, third. Again here I am giving a now here instead of this you give the third. Third. Now section names, sections are labeled. Now you need to give link to that one. So in order to give link as it is, you have to use HREF, but only you will get hash symbol before that. FIREST first. Now here what I am giving is 1 and close anchor tag. This is for the first one. Next HREF, again give the hash, hash symbol you give. Second I am giving 2, close anchor tag. Next term HREF equals to hash, third, next to 3 I am giving, next close anchor tag. Now we will execute this. Control S, file save, hyper it is. File, what is the name of the file? Hyper. You can see here 1, 2, 2 is missed. Why 2 is missed? 2 second. Here I have not closed double quotes. Now save it. Refresh this. Now 1, 2, 3. 3 is missed. Again I have not given double quotes. Save it, refresh this. Now using 1, 2, 3, just a minute, here we'll give the break tag so that you will get clearly. Break tag. Break tag, just I am breaking this. Save this, come to browser window, refresh this. See, these are the paragraphs, okay, and these are the nested links. So example, right now we are in a third paragraph, and if you are clicking on this one, you see the cursor pointer, it will go to the first one, this one. Now you are in the second here, no? This is the second one. You will be in the same document. You are not moving anywhere. Okay. So this is a internal link. Okay. Link within a page. You won't move anywhere. You will be in the same page if you create a internal links. Clear all of you? Example, you are in the first paragraph and you are clicking on this. You will be in the same location. If you are clicking on that also, you are in the same location. See, you are getting, these are the hyperlinks, but you are not moving anywhere. Okay, so this is about hyperlinks and core attributes. Mail to hyperlink, only one program left. That program I am giving you as a homework. Once you practice, if you won't get, just WhatsApp me. I will explain that program also. I hope you all understood. थैंक यू।